Wrestling fans, Cowboy Jack here ringside at ICWA as Jedi Jared facing one of his toughest opponents to date. And that's this man making his way to the ring here. ICWA General Manager Tony Kilgore making his way to the ring, and you see R-Corp there escorting him to the ring. That's not a good sign, any way you want to look at it, for Jedi Jared as he takes on Tony Kilgore here tonight at ICWA. What a contest coming up for you. When I got the call to... And it was asked to do the commentary for this. I was honored and esteemed to take on the responsibility and the role here to do this. So we're watching Tony Kilgore make his way around the ring. You can tell the fans here, not too big a fan of the ICWA general manager. For good reason, you know. He's opened his mouth and... I know Tony. Sometimes he opens his mouth a little too much, and I think he may have opened it up just enough to stick his foot, maybe even both feet, into his own mouth. At least he's trying to be a gentleman, swinging from the ropes there. Oh. Tony's aiming to have him swinging from the rafters tonight, but if Jedi Jared gets his way, Tony Kilgore won't stand a chance. R-Corp looking very confident as they up. Now we're awaiting the arrival of Jedi Jared. Senior official Carlos Stapleton, his father and mentor, the crowd here at ICWA tonight. Fired up. With his entourage in tow. Jedi Jared making his way to the ring, as you just heard. Along with the ultimate zebra, Carlos Stapleton. The man who I've worked with quite a few times, along with Jedi Jared. I know quite a few people in this ring. Some fortunately, some unfortunately, but you know, it is what it is. I'm here to call the shots tonight, though. And look forward to a very interesting match. We'll be back to the action here in just a few moments. And here we go. We are back to wrestling action. Well, lightsaber action as Jedi Jared takes the ring there with Carlos Stapleton, his father and mentor, in his corner. And the crowd already behind Jedi Jared as R-Corp is giving Tony some last-minute advice, if you will. I don't think Tony really needs the advice. He needs R-Corp to really have his back if this thing goes south. But the question is, who will it go south for as R-Corp leaves the ring? And now Carlos Stapleton with a high five of encouragement there to Jedi Jared as he leaves the ring, backing down to the apron to have Jedi Jared's corner have his back. And there's the bell as Tony and Jared. Jared face to the ring. There we go. Strike from both opponents. Oh, and already a hit from Jedi Jared here. Tony not happy with him, but now Jared back on the offensive here. Tony Kilgore on the defense. You can tell Tony is already feeling what Jedi Jared has brought to the ring tonight in this battle. Oh, and another strike from Jared across the back. Tony not happy, and neither is R-Corp on the apron here. Strikes back from Tony to Jared, and another one from Jared landing on Tony. Tony not happy at all. Oh! And another one right to the midsection of Tony. Tony Kilgore getting his midsection handed to him, it looks like. Jared with those midsection strikes, very effective here. Jared not letting up on the offense. Tony having to play a lot of defense here. And the crowd still behind Jared. Oh, and another midsection attack. Jared definitely with the upper hand here. And another one from Jared. Tony definitely on the losing end of this so far. Oh, man, and another great offensive attack from Jedi Jared. Tony needs to keep both hands on that lightsaber, if you ask me. He's sloppy in the ring here tonight. And you can tell the fans behind Jared. And that's getting to Tony. That's getting into his head, getting into his psyche. He's got to get that noise here out of his head. Going for a timeout here. R-Corp up on the apron now. Referee's calling. Jedi Jared's won this one, but maybe this first round here. Definitely serves it correctly. It's a best of three. Mr. Carlos giving Jedi Jared some words of encouragement. Some ideas, probably a new game plan here to put Tony in. Have him done for, but Tony over here is getting pretty cocky, pretty confident. He's loosening up the shirt as R-Corp just jumps down for the ring there. I don't really think they offered the board some encouragement, but it was just more fuel for his ego. You know, Tony Kilgore has one of the biggest egos in ICWA as the general manager here. And now, looks like Tony might be actually on the offensive here. One-handed strikes against Jedi Jared. Jedi Jared now has to play on the defense. Tony Kilgore. Oh man, with another one to that left leg of Jedi Jared. That left leg taking the most impact out of anything we've seen so far in this match. Either one. And Tony just wearing out the left leg of Jedi Jared here. And now R-Corp trying to get the fans here of ICWA behind Tony, but that's not gonna happen. You hear them quite silent. But Tony not giving in. Not giving up. Oh man, and another one, Jedi Jared on the defensive end here. And you see it over and over. Tony Kilgore getting the better of Jedi Jared. Jedi Jared has to come up with something. He has to come up with a way to get Tony Kilgore out of his head now. What does that have to do? Taking this much damage from the general manager of ICWA in front of this crowd here tonight. What does that have to do with the mental stamina and mind game of Jedi Jared? And now you see Tony, he's been doing this most of this round, just fighting with one hand and the other hand casually behind his back. He's some kind of modern day Zorro without the hat in the end. The eye bandit. And now Tony just talking smack in the ring to Jedi Jared. That's not going to be good for him in the long run. And then the referee calls for the end of second round. Obviously, yes. General manager Tony Kilgore got the upper hand this round. That's unfortunately, that's not to be expected. We've seen Tony Kilgore come from behind in the past. But we've also known that Tony Kilgore is the man who likes to play by the rules. Tony Kilgore usually comes from behind because he's got something up his sleeve. He's got a secret weapon. He's got somebody that's ready to bend the rules if not break them when that referee's back is turned, and now you see R-Corp back up on the apron. There's not much they can tell the man at this point that he doesn't already know. But he's got Jedi Jared on the other side, as you see Carlos Stapleton giving Jared some last words of encouragement as they get into round three here. This round's going to cut. And there's the bell. Referee calling for it twice there. The bell keeper needs to wake up over there. Tony Kilgore getting a little confident here, getting a little cocky. He's talking smack. But Jedi Jared getting the upper hand here. It was an even match this round. One all, but Jedi Jared with the upper hand. Tony not happy. Oh, man, that's a sign of Tony I haven't seen in a while. Somebody younger than him, smaller than him, getting the upper hand here. And Jedi Jared is loving every minute of it, and so is this crowd. Oh, but that's Tony Kilgore gets a shot to the midsection. And Jared getting a shot on the back here. Round three is coming very, very even here. I don't even know. I can't keep track. It's tit for tat. One strike matches the other. Tony Kilgore and Jedi Jared here. Even, if you ask me, when it comes down to round three. Jedi Jared not giving up on the offensive. And now just laying it into Tony Kilgore. He's got him backed up into the corner here. And it's over. Referee calls for it over. Jedi Jared looks to be the winner of this match. We're just waiting word from the official. And yes, Jedi Jared, the winner of round three. ICWA fans loving. But now, hold on a second. It's over, yo. What's our core doing in the ring here? This is a lightsaber match. This is not a wrestling match. I know that that's what ICW is known for, you know, the wrestling, but hold on a second. Somebody just told me, what? Is this who I think it is? This is absolutely who I think this is. That music can only mean one man is about to head through the curtain.
Look at that! Oh my God!
Not head!
Oh.
Oh. I'm wondering the same thing. What's he doing here?
Tony Kilgore. I thought this was supposed to be a fair one-on-one first ever crown. Even up the odds.
That sounds pretty good to me. Tony Kilgore back bringing Tony Kilgore bringing R-Corp to the ring. But I don't think anybody expected this. I've heard this music a couple times in my career. That siren. And if the music that plays after it. It's wow! Yeah. R-Corp and Tony Kilgore just bit off more than they could chew. Damon Biggs making his way to the ring. You know, I expected a couple of different people. I expected more people, but I tell you what, let's be honest here, with the size of R-Corp and Tony Kilgore, Damon Biggs can equalize this playing field. Well, I would say Damon Biggs can even this playing field and equalize the score. But Nodhead just said somebody else is coming. Holy cow. guesses who else I think it is. Not only is the playing field even and equal, it is totally on the side of Jedi Jared, because that means one of the best and biggest, literally, tag teams in East Tennessee is back together. Dale Rebel Henderson alongside Damon Biggs. Does that mean the Southern Bad Boys are back? I think so. Oh, and Henderson with that kendo stick in hand. And you see R-Corp getting their butts out of the ring real quick as the Southern Bad Boys back Tony Kilgore, the general manager, into the corner. And general manager or not, Southern Bad Boys ain't taking crap from nobody. And they stepped in between Jedi Jared and Tony Kilgore. But wait, Carlos has Jared's lightsaber. And Dale just handed Jared the kendo stick. Oh, man! Shots across the back of Tony! Jedi Jared trading a lightsaber for a kendo stick. That's the kind of insane action we're used to seeing here at ICWA. R-Corp coming to the aid of Tony Kilgore. They better get his butt out of the arena. Not hit. Letting R-Corp and Dale Henderson, or Tony Kilgore, know. It's welcome as Damon Biggs and Dale Henderson chase R-Corp to the back. Oh! Damon Biggs bringing Tony back out to the ring to face some more kendo stick shots from Jedi Jared. Carlos Stapleton, Jedi Jared's lightsaber, chasing Tony back out of the ring, but he's running through the crowd to get out of here. Good thing they kept that door up. Tony Kilgore running out of the entire arena now. R-Corp getting it from some of Jedi Jared's entourage. And the Southern Bad Boys running block, saving R-Corp from getting the beat down from Jedi Jared. Hey, Carlos Stapleton, this is not the outcome I expected, but I'll tell you what, when Tony Kilgore brings two guys like R-Corp to the ring, I expected some good people to have the back of Jedi Jared. And there you see Damon Biggs raising the hand of your new ICWA lightsaber champion, Jedi Jared. Raising that title above his head, victorious. I was about to say, somebody play that man's music. And there you have the ICWA lightsaber champion. What an awesome title win from Jedi Jared here at ICWA today. I would say thanks to the help of the Southern Bad Boys, but Jedi Jared didn't need their help to defeat the ICWA general manager Tony Kilgore tonight. But Southern Bad Boys definitely made sure that Jared was taken care of when R-Corp decided they'd jump in the ring there. The Southern Bad Boys and Jedi Jared. That makes me wonder what else is coming up here at the ICWA. Holy cow, fans. Oh, it has been a blast. Thank you so much for watching on behalf of everybody involved. And the crew here at ICWA. It's good to see the Southern Bad Boys back together, but more importantly, it's good to see Jedi Jared, your new ICWA lightsaber champion. I'm Cowboy Jack Heath-Sneed. I'll see y'all next time as we leave you with this wonderful picture of Jedi Jared, lightsaber champion.